All right, everybody, welcome back to Seltzer Sunday. What's good? We got the bachelor party edition going on. We're here in sunny Denver, up at this badass Airbnb. This is a great edition. We're gonna really talk about five today, giving you five for one. So looking forward to this. We got a good lineup, got some new ones, got some ones that came out of left field, but we're gonna really enjoy this. All right, we got some really good lineups today. All right, let's talk about the ones we're gonna sample. First, we're going to circle back to White Claw. This is the standard in Seltzer Nation. So we all know this. We all like White Claw. We all like Truly. But today we're going with the mango flavor. Up next, we've tried Bud Light Seltzer before, but we're going to compare it, see how it stacks up against the White Claw mango. So we got Bud Light Seltzer mango too. Next, this one kind of came out of left field, just wandering through the liquor store, but Jose Cuervo has a hard seltzer too, so welcome to the game, Jose Cuervo. They have their Jose Cuervo Playa Mar Hard Lime. It's made with Jose Cuervo tequila, only natural flavors, no sugar, no artificial sweeteners, gluten-free too for all you folks out there. Next, one I just picked up pretty randomly off the rack. It's called Lifted Libations. This is more of a cocktail in a can. It's organic vodka soda. It's the grapefruit flavor, so we're gonna see how this stacks up against all the other seltzers. Lastly, this is a Colorado brand. It's called Spiked Snowmelt. It's a craft hard seltzer. It's from Upslope Brewing Company, upslope from here in Denver. So we're going with their pomegranate acai. Get some antioxidants and some craft hard seltzer in our lives. Okay, we got some special guests today here on the show. This is Brant Antolik. He's our bachelor of the weekend. We're here celebrating him. Big fan of seltzers. How long do you say you've been in the seltzer game?
Been a seltzer guy my whole life, you know?
Yeah? Did you go get with hockey before and after hockey game?
You know, you probably get made fun of, but they're more refreshing than the old Molson.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Have you had the Labatt seltzer yet?
I have not, but it's on my list.
All right, perfect. All right, up next we have Andy Renfrew. This guy is a local kid from Fort Collins, correct?
Colorado Springs,
just south of here in Denver. So he's been showing us around and a good buddy of the show. So welcome.
Thank you for having me.
All right, man. Looking forward to seeing your reviews. Last but not least, the man, the myth, the legend, Beef Jerky.
Beef Jerky, aka Dirk Alert, yep. Aka Big.
So what do you think about it? This is we know White Claw is our standard on Seltzer Sunday. It's hard to beat it.
There are like
a couple I've found that are getting up there, but
I like the George Washington part of seltzer.
Yeah, they found it. They invented America.
You know, the mango was a really good addition outside of the white cherry.
That's right.
White cherry was a hard mango.
Yeah. We did the Clementine one earlier in the season, so that was like an 8.5. So. This one's up there.
I'm gonna give it a. Too early to rank.
Oh, we could. We can wait. Wait a little bit. Hold off on the rankings.
Okay.
Yeah.
Enjoy it,
Andy. What do you think about this delicious seltzer?
It's desperate.
What's mango? How's the mango?
Like best flavors. Chance down to water.
Okay. We haven't circled that one yet.
Never had that one.
Yeah.
Can't find the variety pack.
No. Variety pack, too.
Eric Clark, what do you think about it?
I think that's the standard.
This is the standard.
I think this is the standard White Claw. It's the middle new flavor.
Yeah.
It was the originals, the lime, the black cherry, grapefruit, and the
raspberry.
This one came out in the 32-ounce cans. Man, you can just suck those things down real good.
We call them at Seltzer Sunday and for Seltzer Nation is a pool patio pounder. Triple P, baby.
Triple P.
So this is definitely a pool patio pounder.
Yep.
Agreed.
You can play Stat Cup, you're a celiac guy.
That's true.
Or gal.
Yeah, we're pro celiac here. We're here to support everyone.
Just a sorority girl trying to stay GF.
Yeah.
Play Slap Cup with it.
It's very versatile.
It's got the carbonation to where it's still fair.
It's not a abrasive flavor. It's no. very slight.
It's silky.
Yeah, it's subtle. It's a subtle flavor.
All right, results are in, y'all. This is the first of our five reviews today. This, again, is the White Claw Mango. So first, going to turn it over to our Bachelor of the Weekend, Mr. Brent. Talk about it, buddy.
You know, it's a real light, real tasty, full patio pounder.
Triple P.
Very refreshing. Little sweet.
Brent!
A little sweet like me.
That's right. That's right, Jordy.
But, Part 8.1.
I love it. All right, Andy.
Well, this is my first time ranking these, so rookie here, but I'd probably give it an 8.0.
8.0.
Not too flashy, not the best thing you'll ever drink, but it's something that you can drink consistently.
Okay. So I like it. There you go. All right, Big Dirk, a lurk.
Okay. Like I said, it's a very subtle taste. It was a tide over for the new variety pack. Out in the 32 ounces, full party pounder.
That's right, baby.
So I'm gonna go crazy with it. 8.7.
8.7. Wow. That is the highest score on Seltzer Sunday so far. So everyone else needs to step up to the plate. All right, last.
Looking forward,
but not least.
Bud Light.
That's right. But first, this one. Cheers, y'all. I think I've discussed a lot in previous episodes. I love mango. Mango is awesome. It's really hard to beat. We've had some ones that kind of didn't really meet the mango standard, but this does. I mean, this is 8.0 today. So it's right there. Anything above 8, I mean, go buy it immediately. If you want to go to the pool today, buy this. All right, everyone, welcome back. Next up, we have the Bud Light Seltzer mango flavor. We're doing a direct comparison for this to White Claw mango and to other mangoes that we've had. So this is a pivotal moment in the history of Seltzer Nation and in the Seltzer history. Mango versus mango, who wins?
It tastes like all the other flavors.
Yeah, it doesn't stand out, so yeah, it's gonna be hard to get a. What do you think, Brent?
You know, I just wanted to bring up for Seltzer Nation. I just stumbled across this song last night, and I think it's become the theme song to my bachelor party.
I think so.
If you haven't heard Rockstar featuring Roddy Ricch with DaBaby,
put it on rotation now.
Put it on rotation.
Yeah.
Yeah, just to make sure that it's clear, this is not the greatest thing I've ever had. Huge Bud Light guy.
Yeah.
Before, one Bud Light would kill me, but now I have to stick with Bud Light seltzers, and I think if I had to, I'm going to go with the White Claw.
Yeah, okay.
It's a little too... A little too synthetic mango flavor.
All right. Respect me. Not everyone can meet the standards.
Synthetic is a good you know, it's about to be 100 degrees. I would definitely still count this, you know?
Is it still triple P?
With, like, not capital P's, like lower
little,
P's.
Little P's. Okay. You gotcha.
Triple P's.
All right, we're back. Results are in. We've been talking through this Bud Light Seltzer Mango. I'm going to turn it over to the guests right now. Brent?
I think they were a little more generous, but I'm also Seltzer
5.0. Not trying to show off, but not trying to underachieve.
Not trying
to be arrogant
either,
just top
real.
All right. Andy?
For my review, I didn't really like it. I'll give it a 5.5. When you venture below the 5.0 realm, around there, something that I wouldn't drink personally. There's nothing else I'd drink that.
Yeah. 5.5, all right. Okay. Big Dirt?
I'm going to be a little bit more generous, I guess, because I like the mango, but 5.9.
5.9?
Yeah. Take it.
Hey.
Okay.
5.9. Hey, results are in, and let me give this a whirl. We brought up a lot of good points. Just doesn't have quite the mango and the texture flavor that the White Claw does, but it's okay. But I'm gonna give it a 6. It's not my first choice to go by. I'm gonna go by the White Claw first, but still, it's very palatable. And so try it, but I would go get White Claw first.
Yeah.
I'm really biased.
Yeah.
You know, you never say judge a book by its cover,
But look at this can. The
can is
very festive, but it's quite cheap. You know, it's just straight film going. Also, I don't speak Spanish, but Clymar pretty much sounds like police knock it down. So,
close.
I really have.
I believe it translates to beach sea.
Beach sea, yes. Yes, that is the old translation.
Now, tequila is good for your digestion, but when you drink out of a wine cup, you kind of get smothered in tequila.
Yeah, the essence of tequila is not...
It's a very...
I
think crushing these at the pool with a can, you're not getting submerged in tequila. And it's like a mark.
I agree. The scent is pretty brutal, yeah. But the taste is like very subtle.
Yeah.
It's not the smell is definitely a little overpowering, but the taste is not.
Yeah. I think it's all the hardness of a margarita without.
Yeah. I mean this is a seltzer, so I mean if people want the margarita flavor.
It kind of tastes like a watered down. Like you made a margarita, put some ice in it, let it sit out in the sun.
Talk to their marketing people because it's almost like a really well done ranch water.
Yeah.
And they're trying to sell as a seltzer.
Yeah.
I can say one thing, P-Shell, that idea, we actually did that with mimosas with White Claws and it was actually pretty phenomenal. No, we did it with the strawberry ones. It was actually really good. So check out strawberry and orange juice. It's pretty good.
I like it too.
Okay. We just talked through and we got you the results for the Jose Cuervo Clymar Hard Seltzer Lime. So start out with Brent, man. What's up? Tell us about this.
So I just looked on Amazon and it turns out you can buy packs of 30 of these. So I just bought 12 cases of
8.9. Wow. We're setting records today
it
here on Seltzer
Sunday.
If it wasn't
so hot up here, it might have been a 9.1.
Ooh, yeah.
And if our refrigerator worked.
Yeah, our refrigerator works.
It might taste, but I might be more generous too. All right, Andy.
It's hard to compare this one with tequila to a regular hard seltzer. It's different flavors, different styles. I'm not a huge fan of it. Yeah. I personally wouldn't go buy it myself. A little too watered down for my liking.
Yeah.
I'm going to give it a 5.0.
5.0.
Wow. Brutal, sir.
Hey. It's to each person's discretion.
So the
Dirk.
I really think the scent is kind of what brings it down for me. It's very smooth.
Yeah.
A lot smoother than the Bud Light Seltzer, so I respect that. I think it's a little bit higher than that. I'd say a 6.6.
Okay, 6.6. I like it.
We're all over the board.
We're over the place, man. Well, I think I expressed probably my facial expressions and body language in earlier portions of us talking about this, but tequila and me and the scent, just I don't know, but I'll give it one more chance.
I do like how it tells you the nutrition facts.
It does.
Back, honestly.
So, I think it can grow on you, but for me, like, at a first encounter, I'm giving this a 5.0, so just... I don't know. It'll take a while for me to circle back to it.
Mr. Pat, before we cut it off, I think that this is the best lime seltzer that I've had.
Really?
So the White Claw and all that, so that's why I gave it a higher rating than what I would have given a regular lime seltzer. So that's kind of why that's the higher rating.
You heard it here first, folks.
It doesn't have any weight, but it definitely is better than the White Claw. And White Claw is a staple here.
It's hard to really push anything above the White Claw. The only one I've had better is Wild Basin Boozy Water. That stuff is awesome.
And again, that's the only lime seltzer I've had.
It's lime,
the Truly and the White Claw. So
that's true. All right, you heard it here first, folks. So we're all over the place on this one, but pick it up if you are curious. Next, guys, we're gonna go with this Spiked Snow Melt. We'll get back to you in a second and give you our thoughts. Well, we're sampling it. What do you think? What are we thinking?
Just the smell alone. Who here has had Flintstone vitamins?
Oh man. Oh, amen, yes, dude. Right. Man. Just eat your Flintstone vitamins. I think this was like
the, I just had a flashback around 4 years
somewhere
old.
This is somewhere in between like the red one and the orange one. I think that was like Pebbles or Bam Bam.
Yeah.
Yeah. Chalky.
But yeah, man, even this,
yeah, it definitely tastes like Tums or something yeah. like that.
Maybe, because you think it's
the aftertaste lingers too. It's yeah. just like there.
Chalky.
The aroma is pretty good.
Yeah.
I think everybody
currently
eats Flintstone Vitamins.
Flintstone Vitamins. Yeah, that's it.
Boulder, Colorado.
It is a local brewer, so that's nice. We're supporting local, but if you didn't have your vitamin today, folks, drink one of these.
I agree. It's got a lot of...
Yeah.
The pomegranate and acai is good for antioxidants.
Oh, that was pomegranate,
yeah.
Patagranate,
yep. Project Patagranate. Other project, Pat.
Don't think
that ever. Yeah. It's tough.
If you're on a desert island and trying to get drunk, this is what you go to, I guess.
Do you guys remember the Got Milk commercial? Where the guy is in the desert and pours the milk and there's sand in it? I feel like that guy.
All right. Hey, everybody. Welcome back. We're going to go ahead and... give you our thoughts and our rankings for the spiked snow melt. This is the pomegranate acai flavor. So turn it over to the bachelor of the weekend.
I'm trying to behave for Ross Durkee and the family people.
Children.
This one's rough. I say a 5 is slap cup approved. You can kind of slam those. This isn't my rating. I'm kind of trying to get my caliber. Slap them and you don't have any heartburn about wasting them. This is borderline that 2 where if you take a shot you throw up for me. So I'm gonna give it a 3, you know. No heartburn pounding these, but no telling if I'm gonna yap them.
Yeah.
It's slap them.
Yeah. It's tough.
Yeah.
Andy?
The Flintstones vitamins really got me. Blast from the past.
Y'all heard it here first.
Eric?
So the flavor lingers a little too much for my liking. The Flintstone vitamin thing, I'll give it a point. So like I said, I'm giving it a point for nostalgia's sake because I like my Flintstone gummies.
Okay. You heard all the other rankings and thoughts for this, so I'll give you mine. And I can't say that I disagree with them. The after flavor, the chalkiness, the Flintstone vitamins vibe we get from this, I'm giving this a 3 too. This I don't think I can buy this again, but go try it for yourself, but it's not for us on Seltzer Nation.
Actually, thanks Julian for the donation.
Thank you, Julian. Shout out to Julian Michaels. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the final sampling of Seltzer Sunday today, and I'm going to turn this over to Brent Analick for the final introduction.
So we've got the Liquid Libations Organic Vodka Soda. Couple
drink.
Initial thoughts here.
Local drink,
Denver.
Again.
Really impressive packaging from afar. Also, very good labeling. You see the GF, the USDA Organic.
Did their homework.
Yeah, I guess they're legit. But couple things that scare me about this. Vodka soda. Vodka is not my thing. There's a best buy date on alcohol.
Interesting.
And then, you know, the packaging is just kind of cheap. So, it's
we'll let you know what we think.
Yeah, we'll let you know how it goes.
Yeah, so.
It's just so flavorless. I think the dirty ice cubes.
Dirty ice cubes.
The dirty ice cubes is spot on. No flavor.
Like, you know those, like, really
ice cubes. Yeah. That's how it tastes. It tastes like that.
You just put those in a cup and you let them melt.
100%. I really don't think I can finish a full can of this.
I'm not sure if I can finish the sample.
Wow,
we're setting records highs and lows today on Seltzer Sunday because we've had the highest scores and we're probably gonna have the lowest score. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times.
It's irresponsible because you drink that and like you're just like, oh, I'm drinking dirty water or dirty ice water. And like,
hey. I don't even get any grape.
Nah, this is
like zero grape.
It's like it's the worst. I might as well drink a LaCroix, like regular LaCroix. Clean water.
Grapefruit isn't even the best choice of flavor to have.
Like, that's the worst White Claw flavor.
Oh, yeah.
It's honestly not even a grapefruit flavor in it.
Yeah. Hint, maybe? Just hint.
I think we really need to go after these companies' marketing folks.
They're doing a poor job.
Like, we're playing a game of Clue just to, like, try to even, like, find the hint of flavor.
If you pour that in a can and you don't tell me what it is, I couldn't guess.
I think if we took the mop from the floor last night and the table that we were cleaning up and rung it into this,
it might taste
better
similar
than this.
Man, you're hearing it here first, fellas.
Fortune. Wow. Ladies.
Do not buy this.
Good.
Do not buy this. Do not buy this.
All right, everyone, welcome back. This is the final ranking for the final sample of Seltzer Sunday. We're going to go ahead and turn it over to the guests today. Brent?
I really wish the outcome was different. We started off really high. This was just plain awful. 1.9.
We're not even rounding up to 2.
We're not below the 2.
Wow.
That's last minute decision.
Andy.
That's heartless.
Yeah.
808s and heartbreak.
It really wasn't good. There's not really any redeeming qualities in my mind about it. I would never pick this up. Even if it was given to me for free by someone, I probably would turn it down. Not going to drop below the 2s because I feel like how we said that's yakking realm.
Yak realm.
I wouldn't quite yak on this just because it doesn't really have a whole lot of substance to it. So I'm going to go 2.5.
Big Dirt, James.
Yeah, I'd go with the 2.2. Like, that's what I would do. It's getting close to that point where, one, it's not what it says it is. It's definitely not grapefruit. It's more paint thinner than anything, so
2.2. Yeah, this is tough, guys, but we're here. The goal is to try every seltzer out there. Everyone needs to know what these are like. I mean, how are you going to decide? That's why you have me. Yeah, there's no flavor. It's supposed to be a vodka soda, which with some grapefruit. It's like a game of Clue trying to find this grapefruit flavor, so I'm giving this a 2.1. I can't see myself ever buying this again, but that's it.
I think this could be like the triple C, like the cool crushing cocktail in a can, maybe the quad C.
Yeah.
C4, I don't know, but it's definitely not a triple P by any means.
No, not at all.
No,
we're not bringing this to the pool ever.
Let's go play some Slap Cup.
Okay, guys, we've had an awesome, awesome Seltzer Sunday out here for the Bachelor Party Edition. This was awesome. Gave you a 5-for-1 review, play-by-play. As always, you DM me at OtherProjectPat for any suggestions, anything else you want to see on the show. Special thanks to our guests today.
Brent, thank you, buddy.
Thanks for having me.
Great Bachelor Party, man.
Yeah.
It was awesome.
Yeah, we'll try to, crush some patio pool
founders,
man.
We'll do it, triple P.
Anybody wants to donate some White Claws?
Do it.
To the bachelor party, just DM Project Pat.
At Other Project Pat.
Thanks for having me, Pat.
You bet, buddy. Man, awesome. We'll circle back and have you guys around. We'll do the OKC edition soon.
Good having you. Or good having me.
Good having you, buddy.
All right. It was awesome, guys. We'll talk soon. Happy Seltzer Sunday.